majority of South Africans have been saying there is something wrong with the electoral system. Something has got to be done in order to be able to fix this problem. And we therefore got together as civil society organizations in order to try to confront that, because we're not convinced that Parliament will actually be able to come up with something again, or we've got our own doubts about how far the panel that is appointed by Parliament is going to go, given the experiences that we've already gone through. I've already indicated some of the experiences that we have had in terms of the electoral reform. So we, as Boikanyo has indicated, we're not competing with the panel that the minister has appointed. We will complement each other. The approach that Parliament has taken in the past has been largely a technicist approach, where a few people get together. The main criticism has always been that there's not been enough consultation. So that technicist approach is not really helpful in terms of taking the process forward. But also, we feel that with our participation as civil society organizations, we can be able to benefit the country with the collective wisdom of all the organizations that are participant in this process. And we will make sure that the approach that we take, it's a mass-based approach, because we come from civil society organization. And because we come from civil society organization, our inclination is to consult as much as we can. And we will indeed be using that as one of the most important approaches going forward. We will be able to develop, using the collective intelligence of everyone, we will be able to develop some kind of policy options that the country can look at. We'll look at the pros and cons of whatever we're going to be developing, so that people can actually be able to see how we arrive at a particular decision. And the fact that we've got now a technical person, a researcher, who's going to be assisting us in this particular process, I think it's very helpful. Just to reiterate in terms of the objectives of this panel, and I'll go through what we have here. The first objective is to analyze the current electoral system in relation to the state of our democracy. Secondly, to engage with formal state processes regarding the electoral reform. I've already indicated that we don't see ourselves as competition to the panel that has already been appointed. We will be trying to complement whatever they will develop, and then we'll see whether there is a point of synergy in this process. To develop a framework or a blueprint for an alternative electoral system that will contribute towards deepening democracy and strengthening accountability. And lastly, to mobilize civil society and popular movements behind a long-term and broad electoral reform and other democratic reform campaigns.
So in the formation of the panel, put out a call at the beginning of the year, a public call. Immediately after that, we also sent out invitations to various organizations asking if they'd be interested in work around this, around electoral reform. So some of those organizations heeded that call, and we have those people here today. Part of the reason that we reached out to organizations and asked for representatives from those organizations is also looking at the fact that some of those organizations and social movements have constituencies, right, have the reach that we would like to have if we want to have public participation processes during this process, right? So we've got 9 representatives as part of the panel who are part of different organizations in different spheres of civil society.